Hello. In this course, I'll talk about the Stream Library. It's a basic feature of Pharo. We'll see what streams are, how to use them, and when they can be useful. What is a stream? It's an object that enables to iterate over a collection of elements, a sequence of elements. This sequence could be a collection in memory, a network flow, a file, etc. A stream keeps the current position in memory. As you use the stream, you can move forward or backward to read from or write elements to the stream. An overview of the stream's API. To create a stream, there are a few objects over which you can use the messages readStream and writeStream to create streams from a file or a collection, for instance. You can create streams this way. This message, streamContents, is sent to a collection and takes a block as a parameter, which receives a stream. The use of a stream within this block creates a collection the method will eventually return. We'll see how to use this method in the end. In this case, you directly ask a class, either readStream, writeStream, or readWriteStream, to create a new instance over a collection. These three methods can read one or several elements up to a point. These two elements write an element or a collection of elements to the stream. There are a few examples through which you can read from a stream. First, create a stream. I'm creating a read stream from a collection. The collection contains all letters between A and F. There's one character for every element in the collection. Create a stream over the collection. Let's look at the characters one by one. Once the stream is ready, you may start by sending the message next, which will return an element right after the current position when the stream is initialized. The current position is 0 at the beginning of the stream. Next returns the first element, which is A. If I call next at this time, I'll get A, then B, then C, one at a time. By calling next, the position moves by one row at a time. If I call next once and get A, I can send the message up to and one element. This method returns all the elements between the current position and the element I placed as parameter. With A, I'm in position 1. If I send up to D, it returns what's between the current position and D, B, and C. D is consumed by the stream. It means the stream is now located right after D. D isn't returned. Stream position returns the current position. The position starts at 0. 0 is located before the first element, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. We're right before E and after D. Now, if I send the message up to end to the stream, I'll get all the elements located between the current position and the end of the stream. That's E and F. The stream maintains a current position I can move forward, thanks to a few methods. You can also write to a stream. The first step is to create the stream. With array new 6, I create a size 6 array. I send the message writeStream to create a stream on the array to be able to gradually fill it in thanks to the stream. I store the stream in the variable stream. I first send the message nextPut1, which takes one element and adds it to the current position in the stream. My array now contains 1 followed by 5 empty cells. The message nextPutAll takes a collection of objects which are appended to the stream. After sending nextPutAll to the stream, I get an array that contains 1, the result of the previous next put, followed by 4, 8, 2, 6, 7, the result of next put all. Streams are especially useful and efficient to read from and write to object collections. I can also write to and read from files. I'm giving an example of how to write to a new file that doesn't exist yet. In the stream, I type the name of the file. By sending a stream with the message as file reference, I create a reference to a file. This is a file that doesn't exist yet, but I can still get a reference to it. I have a reference to a file, hello.txt. I send the message write stream to the file in order to get a write stream related to this non-existent file. As soon as you write to the stream, the file is created. Now that I have a stream, I send the message nextPutAll with a string. This message writes one character at a time, each element of the string. H, then E, then L, etc. In the end, I close the stream to tell the operating system I'm done writing in the file. And then it can write everything to the storage system and close the file pointer. Now that I've written in the file, I can read it. The file name is displayed as a string. With as file reference, I can create a reference to this file. With read stream, I can open a read flow, a read stream when it comes to this file. With next, I get the first element of the stream. I wrote, "Hello, Pharo." The first element is H. With up to end, I get all the characters between the current position after H and before E and the end of the file. I get "Hello, Pharo" without H, as I already got it thanks to next. One can create collections using streams. It's useful when you want to create collections, and you need code to choose what to gradually include in them. I want to create an ordered collection by sending messages to a stream. From the class ordered collection, I start a new instance, which I turn into a write stream. Thanks to the message next put, I add 1 in the stream. If I type stream contents, I get an instance of the class ordered collection, which contains the value 1 only. These three expressions can be simplified, as shown below. You may send the message stream contents to the class we're interested in, which is ordered collection. I send stream contents to ordered collection. I pass it a block as a parameter, which takes a stream as a parameter. Within the block, I use the stream to gradually fill in the collection. When the block is over, I get a collection. In the block, I type stream next put 1. I add 1 to the stream. It gets added to the collection. When stream contents quits, when this expression is over, I'll get an ordered collection containing 1. Stream contents is useful to create collections from scratch. In the course, we learned about Streams API. There are many methods you should learn about by exploring the classes, thanks to Nautilus Code Navigator. A stream can read from and write to collections in memory, files, the network, etc. A stream maintains a current position. The current position separates the past elements from the future elements. Whenever you write to or read from the flux, the current position changes. Streams can also help create new collections.